Ignition sequence start.
Did you know that NASA's first ever mission operations manager was a Filipina? During a time when women weren't being granted opportunities in male-dominated fields, Angelita Castro-Kelly managed to do what almost seemed impossible, supervising early developmental missions for the Earth Observing System program since her, not just more women, but also more Filipinos were able to enter into the space industry. Yet, why aren't they as known in American history as Neil Armstrong or any of their white counterparts?
It's one small step for man, one giant leap for mankind.
Is there a place for Filipinos in space? For the longest time, Filipino Americans have never been properly acknowledged in US records or artifacts. And if they were, they'd be reduced to merely a fun fact in the books. Still, these weren't able to stop the likes of Chino Roque, who will possibly be the first Filipino to go to space. Chino was selected out of 28,000 applicants. The then 22-year-old CrossFit trainer bagged the opportunity of a lifetime after being recruited into Axe Apollo's Space Camp's space program. But while his expedition has been postponed until further notice, his milestone is still a tremendous achievement not only for his name, but for the Filipino community as well. Chino joins a line of remarkable Pinoys whose contributions were out of this world, literally. Josephine Santiago Bond is a Filipino-American who NASA assigned as their current chief of the Advanced Engineering Development Branch. There's also Genevieve Yang, who made history as one of the team members that launched and landed the Perseverance rover on Mars. And speaking of the Perseverance rover, two other Kababayans took part alongside Genevieve in this massive mission. These are Gregorio G. Villar III and Edward Gonzalez. We can't forget to mention Dr. Josefina Comiso, the senior emeritus scientist at NASA's Cryospheric Sciences Laboratory. Fulfilling a career in space and sciences proves to have no limit too, because earlier this year, a student named William Kevin Abran from the University of the Philippines had his experiment, rotation of dumbbell-shaped objects in space, picked up by the agency. While people of color, including Filipinos, are still being deprived of opportunities, it doesn't mean that there isn't a space for them in STEM industries.
The eagle has landed.
It's been almost a century since the first man walked on the moon. And back then, that very concept was seen as frightening or impossible.
It's all a lie.
I'm afraid so. The government lies. What a surprise.
Our community as well has an extensive history of being, if not left out, discouraged from participating.
To boldly go where no man has gone before.
But those who manage to risk the odds are proof enough that when Filipinos put their minds into something, they are capable of reaching great heights. Join us next time on The Chika Chat.